Welcome. This is Accounting with Bennett Tchaikovsky. Our topic today is non-current liabilities or bonds. And today we're going to be issuing bonds at a discount, both annual and semi-annual. This broadcast is copyright, 2018 by Bennett Tchaikovsky, all rights reserved. No play-by-play of this can be used without express permission of the commissioner. Sorry, guys. It's just when I'm saying this stuff, this is kind of funny. All right. Let's go forward. Okay. So what I want to do is I want to refer you back to the original presentation in bonds, which really talks about how to use the present value tables. But as a refresher, when do discount on bonds payable come about? It happens when my stated rate of interest on the bond is lower than the market rate of interest. And because my bond's stated rate is lower than the market rate of interest, I will have to discount my bond, meaning my bond will sell for less than face value to basically make the bond attractive for investors. And then it will be effectively yielding the market rate of interest. So when I do this as a journal entry, now, without anything else, when we issued a bond at par, meaning that when my stated rate and my market rate were the same, I debited cash and I credited bonds payable. But here we're going to be using, because we're not going to be getting the full amount of cash. Remember, since our interest rate is lower than the market rate, our stated is lower than the market, we're going to get less cash. So what we have to do is create this contra liability account called discount on bonds payable. Now notice, this journal entry here, barring no other types of circumstances, this journal entry will never change. We want to memorize this journal entry because when I'm issuing a bond at a discount, this will be the journal entry I'm going to be using for the initial issuance always. If I'm an intermediate accounting student, it might be a little bit different because if we are doing a bond issuance between interest dates, that's something else. But for here, this, for our purposes here, essentially this is what we're going to be looking at. That journal entry right here doesn't change. But what type of account exactly is discount on bonds payable? Well, since bonds payable is a liability account, the discount on bonds payable is what we call a contra liability account, and it will reduce the carrying value of the bonds. So again, this discount is a friend or a negative friend of the bonds payable. It will reduce the bonds payable. Now, what happens to the discount on bonds payable is that over time, this will be amortized, and essentially what will happen is that upon maturity, the amount of the discount will be zero. But we're gonna save that for a later presentation, and we're right now gonna focus on the issuance. So our first example is we have Aussie Grey, which are the two most amazing cats in the whole wide world. And let me just go here. We've got Aussie Grey Inc. issues a 20-year, $10 million bond with a stated interest rate of 6% on January 1st. The bond will pay interest annually every December 31st, and the market rate of interest is 8%. So we know immediately that this bond will be issued at a discount. Why? The stated rate of interest, or the amount of interest that this bond will pay, is 6%. The market rate of interest, or what that market rate is on the date of issuance, is at 8%. No one wants my bond. Therefore, the bond is going to sell at a discount. So right here, I know for this, I'm being asked to prepare the journal entry, the balance sheet presentation. What I know immediately about my journal entry is that this is always going to be the journal entry when I record a bond at discount, and I just flip these around from the prior example I gave you. So the first thing I want to do is write out this journal entry. I'm debiting cash, debiting discount, and crediting bonds payable. Right now, I only know bonds payable is going to be 10 million, I always show bonds payable at the face value. Or what did I go through and issue these bonds for? So here, 20-year, $10 million bond. So that's what I've got. So to determine the cash proceeds, I need to look at two different things. As we remembered from the last presentation, what we talked about, what gives a bond its value, it's two different things. The first one is going to be the principal or that amount that's going to be paid at the end of the bond's term. So right over here, what does this really mean? I've got a $10 million bond. It's a 20-year bond. When I issue these bonds, the $10 million does not have to be paid back for 20 years. So I'm going to need to present value that amount, basically amount back to today's dollars. The other thing I have here is I have a $600,000 being paid every year for 20 years. So I'm also going to have to present value that back as well. So I'm going to go to the appropriate present value tables. So right over here, basically for the interest portion, the amount of the interest I'm paying is $600,000 per year. Now, what we learned last time is that there's two tables. There's the present value of an ordinary annuity of a dollar, which is what I'm going to be using for my interest payments. And then there's the present value of a dollar, which I use for my principal amount. So here I'm going to go and ask myself the question, how many times am I paying interest? Well, since it's a 20-year bond that's paying interest annually, that means I'm making 20 interest payments. And accordingly, the market rate of interest, or what's the market rate of interest, is going to be 8%. So I'm going to go here 20 periods, and then I'm going to come over here to 8%, and I'm going to get 9.81815. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to multiply that 600,000 times 9.81815, and I'm going to get 5,890,890. That is going to be the value of the interest payments. Remember, those interest payments have a lot of value. I'm being paid the interest every single, I have to pay that interest every single year for 20 years. And as whereas with the principal portion, this $10 million being paid 20 years from now, what's that value? Well, if I go to the present value of a dollar, and again, whatever factor I use for the interest or for the principal, I've got to use for the other one. So interest is being paid 20 times. And then over here, I'm at 8% and I get 0.21. It's time for the readers. Okay, I'm going right here, 0.21455. So I've got here present value of a dollar, 0.21455. And so my total cash received is going to be the 5,890,890 plus 2145,500. So my cash received is going to be 8,036,390. So what we're going to then do is say, okay, so if I know my cash received is 8,036,390, what is going to be the amount of my discount? Well, the amount of the discount is always going to be the face value of the bonds payable, or 10 million, minus the cash received, gives me a discount of 1,963,610. So if we plug this in, and my cash here, okay, so I've got 8,036,390. My discount on bonds payable is going to be the difference between these two amounts right here, or 1,963,610. That's how I'm going through and doing my journal entry. I always compute the cash first, and that discount on bonds payable is going to be the difference. So again, essentially that cash bonds payable will always be at that stated or that face value amount. The cash is going to be the present value of the principal and the interest. And then that discount on bonds payable is going to be the difference between the bonds payable and the cash. And again, this is a journal entry that I would just really commit to memorizing, because if you can memorize this journal entry, you figure out one of the components, you'll get the other part. So, and then we go here and let's go back down. So that's my discount on bonds payable. Now, what would the balance sheet show on the very first day? Well, if I did this on January 1st, 2018, in my non-current liabilities, I'd be showing bonds payable at $10 million, less a discount on bonds payable of $1,963,610, bonds payable net $8,036,390. So that's really what I'm doing here in terms of my valuation. So this is what my balance sheet would look like. And what we said earlier is that this discount on bonds payable is what we call a contra liability account, meaning it is going to be reducing the carrying value of that bond payable. So that was an example of a bond with a annual interest payment. Now, what happens if interest is being paid semi-annually or twice per year? And so let's go through and do this. We've got Aussie Gray, or my favorite company, or OGI, issues a 7-year, $12 million bond with a stated interest rate of 5% on January 1st, 2018. The bond will pay interest semi-annually on June 30th and December 31st. The market rate of interest is 6%, and I just screwed that up. Hold on for a second. Wow, I really messed that up. Hold on, guys. I'm sorry. No, it's still at a discount. I'm an idiot. I was thinking this is a premium. Let me go back here. So Aussie and Gray, so this bond we know is being issued at a discount because the stated rate of interest is less than the market rate of interest. This problem is different than the prior question, though, because the interest is being paid semi-annually. So let's see what the differences are. First off, the form of the journal entry, meaning that a debit to discount on bonds payable, debit to cash, credit to bonds payable, that part is not changing. My bonds payable here is different because the problems change. I need to go figure out the cash. So the difference is when we have a semi-annual bond is going to be the amount of the interest payment, the number of times interest is being paid, because it's semi-annual, and then we're gonna have to adjust the market rate of interest to reflect the semi-annual interest payment. What you'll remember from one of my earlier questions is that when we see an interest payment, we always have to assume that it is going to be an annual rate. Very, very important. So the first thing I need to do is I need to see $12 million times 5%, which is my stated rate of interest, times 6/12, or meaning it's semi-annual. So the amount of the interest payment is going to be $300,000. Again, how do I figure out the interest? It's going to be using the stated rate of that bond. I take the total amount of the bond payable, multiply by the stated rate of interest, but because interest is being paid twice per year, instead of once, I need to make that adjustment. So it's going to be $300,000. So the two streams here, I'm gonna have an interest payment and a principal payment. Now, we're ready to go to the present value tables. Now, when we go to the present value tables, I need to know really two things. How many times is interest being paid, and what is the appropriate market rate of interest? In this case here, it's a 7-year bond, and because interest is being paid twice per year, there will be 14 interest payments. Also at the same time with the interest rate, as interest is being paid semi-annually, we need to be using a semi-annual market rate. So this is essentially the market rate of interest as it was told to us in the problem with 6%. Multiplying this by 6/12 and I'm getting 3%. So when we go to the tables, right, we're gonna head to those hills, we're gonna go to those tables, we're gonna bet a lot of money, we're gonna win a lot of money, it's gonna be a lot of fun, because accounting is fun, right? Okay, so when we go to the tables, we're gonna be using 14 periods at 3%. So for the interest payment, Remember, for the interest payments, I'm going to go to the present value of an ordinary annuity. Why am I doing that? Because I'm getting the same payment over that period of time. I'm going to go to 3% because that is half of the market rate of interest at 14 periods. And I'm going to get 11.29607. So I got 300,000 times 11.29607 equals 3,388,821. But I also have the principal amount. And so here, I'm going to go to the present value of a dollar. And why is that? Because it's a lump sum. That $12 million is being paid to me at the end of the bond's term. So I'm here, I'm going to go to 3% at 14 periods, and I get 0.6612. And the present value of the principal is going to be $7,933,440. So the total amount of cash I'm going to get is going to be $3,388,821 plus $7,933,440. Hopefully that's right. And I'm going to get $11,322,261. So let's put that up here in our journal entry. And so the cash we're going to receive is going to be right here. So if I know that my cash is going to be $11,322,261, what is the amount of my discount? As we said before, you can say, okay, it's bonds payable minus the cash. But if we do this as a journal entry, it's really going to be the amount we need to do to plug it or to make a balance. 677,739. And let's go down here and see that was the amount that we came up with. So this is going to be my discount on bonds payable. So for the balance sheet presentation, when we have a discount, this is what the form will look like. We've got bonds payable. And let's do this on the appropriate date for Aussie and Gray, best company in the world. Not as good as Sahar's mom's class call. That will never be topped. So I got balance sheet as of 1/1/18. So there we go. I've got my bonds payable less my discount on bonds payable is giving me bonds payable net. And that ends our presentation on this portion of bonds. Thank you for joining me today. And I look forward to seeing you on the next one. Thank you. And don't forget to like and subscribe. Thank you.